Hi folks, welcome back to Operation Blood Tower. We're going to go in to try and stop the event retaliation. We've got a couple of changes happening in the squad at the moment. We're going to bring Colonel Moletta PewPew with us. But first, before we launch the mission, I just want to make a couple of quick changes. Let's get him in the race suit. That should be good for him.
Our stealthiest suit, the race, provides a range of movement that technically violates the laws of physics.
Lovely. Check it out. Perfect. Alright. Armor piercing rounds, I think. Lovely. Yeah, so based on the enemies that we've got, I think that we're going to do better with the armor piercing rounds. There's not a lot of actual mech contact apart from the mech longbow and the drone. Okay, before we go in, I just want to quickly get a couple more of this powered weapon since we can make them instantly. We've still got 6 cores. Oh, hellfire projector. Oh, I know a certain Irish lady who's going to be very excited to get their hands on that. And another Shredstorm cannon. Okay. Alright. There's something else that I would like to shoot for, but we'll come back to that a bit later on. Oh, these missions make me nervous. Alright, there you go, Mura. Hellfire projector. Does, instead of 4 to 7, it's now doing 6 to 9 damage. Devastating area of effect flamethrower can lay waste to part of the battlefield. Yeah, excellent. Lovely. Can't wait to get that going. Alright, well, let's level up old Moletta. I've changed his name slightly. I prefer PewPew since he's going to be... The other one was Deadbolt, and that sounded a bit too much like a proper sniper. Wow, low profile. Oh, that's his AWC perk. That is really helpful. That's a good one for him to get, actually. Alright, so we're just going to build him as a gunslinger. And I've gone for Snapshot. Even though I didn't like it at the beginning, when we had it on Daniel, that's because I wanted Daniel to be a long-range sniper. We're going to want Paolo to be much more of a kind of close-range gunslinger build. So Snapshot's a lot more appropriate because it's going to keep moving all the time, and it does allow him to use the sniper rifle as well as the pistol at some points. Now, I also upgraded his pistol a little bit too. All right, quick check. Let's go.
Signal from one of the resistance camps. The aliens are sweeping the whole area, taking out anyone they can find. We're moving in to put a stop to it and protect as many people as we can. Secure the site and neutralize all hostile contacts.
You got it, Bradford. All right, let's get going.
Menace 1-5, hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians. Advent came in hot and so did we. You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
Not generally, but Hans will. Unfortunately, he's stuck right at the back here. That's a bit rubbish. Alright, let's have a little look what we can see around here. There's a big building over there. We've got to rescue 6 out of 13 civilians. And of course, they're going to be killed very rapidly. So, I've got an interesting new plan. Well, let's go and check out Sparky's new head. Look at him! That is really cool. It works so much better with the suit. I'm really glad that they thought of that and then provided a powered head option. He's looking very super futuristic tech nowadays. Alright, so Daniel, we're going to want you to move up to a sniping position, really, aren't we? Maybe we should move our Flux out first. Let's see if this triggers anything.
I'm as graceful as a gazelle.
Very lovely gazelle. Yes, indeed. Firestarter Prime and a Berserker. Okay. Not the friendliest looking pod, but we didn't have too much trouble with this recently, so we'll see what we can do. Alright, so where's Daniel? Where are you, Daniel? There you are. I think you're going to be our effort at dealing with Mr. Firestarter Prime over here.
I'm on it.
We don't need cover, obviously, unless we trigger another pod. In which case, I would have had to use run and gun, but I just wanted to get as close to this thing as possible. Sixteen, very nice. Oh, unlucky, buddy.
Target eliminated.
That's a nice start. Okay. Well, you might as well have a pop at this one. But this one's not going to charge on in, actually, so we need to... Oh, sorry, I've got the game a bit loud in my ears. This one won't move, he's just going to get cranky. So we can just move people up.
Moving to position.
Who else wants to go? Mr. Danger. You going to get a shot from there? Yep.
Okay, I'll go.
More,
Heading out.
Ayordini.
Yeah, we've got plenty of firepower to deal with it. Okay, have we seen any more civilians? Okay, let's deal with this and then I'm going to tell you about my plan for Hans and the civilians. I'm going to have an experiment with a new strategy. It's only really available to us now since we've got some funky new hazmat vests and different sorts of gear that Hans can use. He's on 6 health. Who can finish him off? Oh, Matt. I'd rather not use you, actually, if we can avoid it. You haven't got a shot on, so it's going to have to be you, Matt. 100% chance to kill it. Okay, good. That's what we like. Okay, 2 enemies down.
Target neutralized.
11 to go. Still got 13 civs left also. Alright then, so we don't want to trigger anything else this turn, obviously. You, Mr. Kung, especially with Aiden not in cover.
D'accordo.
Okay. So we're not seeing any other civilians, are we? So since Hans has got the most ridiculously huge move ever, we're going to be using him as a scout, of course, as usual. But not just that, we're going to be using him as our person to run around and collect. I say collect, what I mean is rescue all of the civilians. Now, he's got a lot of advantages for that because he's wearing a special piece of armor which reduces incoming damage from less than 4 tiles. And he's got about an additional 6 hit points from all the different armor he's stacking. So he's on 19 health. You might even need like 8 extra health or something. I can't remember now. It's loads of extra health. Plus he's got Bladestorm and he's also got Implacable. So if he does get into trouble by running around and trying to rescue these, or he does trigger a faceless, he should be in a brilliant position to deal with that. He's also got the vest on that heals him over time. So even if he does get clocked one by a faceless, he should be okay afterwards. Alright, so let's pop one of these beauties out somewhere, shall we? That looks good, mate. Actually, why don't you get all 3 of them? Uh-oh. No. Elite Rocketeer and a Mech Archer. Okay, cool. All those 3 civs are okay for us to rescue. None of them are faceless. Oh no! Oh, Konstantin, mate, that can't be a good way to die. At least it was quick, I bet. Well, there's something doing a lot of moving around right now. Hopefully it's not just walking in, listening to a wall. No, okay. That's some sort of mech. Alright then, Hans. Here is part one of the rescue.
Bestätigt. Rücke aus.
Very, very nice, my friend. Yep. Can you make your way up here?
Nähere mich der Zielposition.
Sweet.
Feindlicher Trupp entdeckt.
Aha, so they're actually right up on the roof. That's handy. Oh, we might have to get them with a nice grenade if we can reach. It's a long old way. Wow, they're miles away. But not so far that we can't. Yeah, we can't actually trigger them. Alright. Well, maybe we should send out another scout off over that way to see what can be seen. I don't know actually. Where are we going to go here? Alright, let's just move up.
I'm compelled to agree.
Matt, you can do some cool stuff here, man. Alright, why don't you get up there? Ah, hang on. That will trigger that pod, won't it? I mean, it would do... Oh, let's go out a little bit more. Okay. Ah, right. It's only where Hans is that's going to trigger the pod. So, in theory, you could grapple to here and that's fine. Let's give that a go.
Grappling.
Might trigger them. Nope. That's cool. How about that? That's good too, huh? Okay, well you might as well go to there. That's a really nice spot. You're in a bit of cover there as well now. Perfect. Okay. You can take some Overwatch. Alright, that's really nice. So we might as well just move up then, gang. We've run up here already, so we can pretty much see... Is that going to make anything happen? No, okay.
Getting it done.
More,
On the move.
Okay, that looks good too.
Roger.
Yeah, I want to put a little bit of Overwatch down. Where's that?
Scanning.
Oh, that looks tempting, but...
Surely there's a more difficult task available.
Chill out, will you, mate? Just chill out. Alright, you can come over there.
Move.
I want to have us look, see where this doom sphere is, assuming that that is going to be that thing that's shooting again on the following turn. You can just overwatch for now, Daniel, mate.
I'm on it.
Hunter drone, huh?
I found another advent mark.
Okay, we might end up with quite a lot of contact now. Daniel. Oh, I'm not surprised you missed that, mate. You're trying to shoot through a garage. Sparky's got it. Nice. So, we've got a mech longbow, heavy mech, advent hunter drone. Longbow's a bit annoying. Hunter drone. Oh, 15 damage. Uh-oh. So we've got 5 bits of contact now.
It's still moving.
Okay. Chance to hit that mech archer. That looks like a great shot to me, Daniel. Why don't you take that one, mate? Perfect. That's that one dealt with.
Hostile target down.
So there's another mech around. He's over there. We've got to deal with that rocketeer up here. Matt, maybe you can sort him out. 75%, that seems good. Lovely.
Hostile target down.
Okay, nice. We'll take a reload, buddy. Are you going to trigger even more stuff? Hopefully not. You could trigger even more stuff, but we'll just deal with it if that happens. No. Okay, cool. Well, I did want to see if he could now see. Yeah, there we go. Look, 64%. Isn't great. Why don't you burn your overdrive here, man? Might as well. 5 turns to cooldown. That's a long time, isn't it? No. That's not worth doing. Okay. So give that a shot, man. 64 is not the best in the world, but... Oh, dear. It's got a lot of shred. If you do hit it, it's got a lot of shred. Oh, that's only a 50% chance now. Alright, take that one down. Alright, lovely.
You've only Advent knew my actual body count.
Alright, what we got happening here then? Okay, hands. You can walk, wander up here now, please, mate, and rescue that person. Okay, so we need to. There's another someone down there. I want to try and get this person because they're in danger of getting shot as well. So how are we going to do that? Aiden, I think this is a job for you, my friend. Can you get right up to that corner? You can, that's nice. Actually, you might not need to get up to that corner. If you go there and trigger something, that's gonna be bad now. We're running out of turns. Alright. Head on over there, buddy.
On it. 44%.
Terrible. Can you grenade it? It's a bit out of range, isn't it? Ah. Oh, we're just going to have to deal with that drone when it arrives, I guess.
Got it covered.
Pew pew. 0%. Okay.
Mi sto muovendo.
Can't see anything now. Why don't you move up again, bud?
Vado in posizione.
Phil. You should be able to see something from up here, right?
What's over there?
No, not apparently not. I think it's going to be Inspire for you, mate. We just need to figure out what we're going to do here. Mangler. You can only overwatch, so this might as well do that. Mora. Why don't you come around here and support this lot? Yeah, no, we're not going to be able to do too much more interesting stuff right now.
I'm trusting you here.
So he's going to get spotted if we go there, which is a real shame. Maybe if you head down there, you can grab that dude next turn. Why don't you give us some eyes over that way, actually? I think that's probably a good shout. Ah, oh, there's a heavy mech, look. What's this hunter drone gonna do? Okay, we can got eyes on the gatekeeper now then. Oh, we've lost three people. Sectoid Commander Viper Elite. Oh, beautiful.
Hit the armor.
Oh, unlucky, Aiden. Unlucky.
Get it together.
Uh-oh. What's it doing? It's bugged out. It's gone mental. What are you up to? Where even is it? Oh, what the hell? It's gone really weird. Okay. You got a good shot on that heavy mech, Daniel. That looks like the one. Now then, we might need to reveal hands here. It's a shame this guy isn't faster. Sick to a commander, huh? If you move up to there, what are you going to be able to see?
Ayordini.
Anything? Ooh! You can see everything in the world from here. So that's actually pretty cool because now we can do lightning hands. Alright, if we blow that up, what is it going to kill anyone? It might kill that person, or it certainly might knock them through the ground, which could kill them. It might kill that person. They've got a big explosion radius, these things. I think maybe not as far as that, though. There's a couple more people around there that we do want to rescue. Well, we might as well blow some of our abilities right now. Let's hit that one. We might do some damage to it. 1 point of damage, not great. Alright, let's go for a bit of face off. A lot of this stuff's got a lot of armor though, which is a problem. We perhaps should have fired at it with armor piercing people first. Yeah, that would have been a much better idea. I just got overexcited with our new guy. In the past, I've sometimes given them armor piercing rounds to deal with that kind of situation. What have we got happening here? Can we get the sectoid as well? Is that going to get the sectoid? Well, look, it's definitely going to get... Let's have a little look. I need to make sure that it does kill that viper. Okay, yes. We can't make it get the sectoid, apparently. Alright, but we can make it kill the Viper and shred the drone in front of him. So let's do that. Perfect. Alright, did that not hit the drone? Are you serious? Oh, bloody hell. That's not good at all. Oh, this is not going very well. Okay, Matt, you're gonna... Oh, I misclicked. Oh, everything's going terribly bad. Oh, whatevs. Okay, 100% chance. All right, give us some shred on that thing, please, mate. That's it. That's even better, Matt. Thanks for sorting us out there, buddy, because we were in a bit of trouble.
Target eliminated.
Okay, good. Now then. No, we don't need to shoot that. If you could open that door, though, that would be helpful. Now, what can you see in there? You've got a shot on from there.
Moving to position.
83, let's try that. Perfect. Thanks, Mara. So we've got that annoying sectoid up top. And we might well have a faceless incoming. Okay. Aiden, you can be the guy to rescue this bloke. Nice, get out of here, please. Oh no, that's terrible news. Oh, shitting. Crap, I really didn't think that was going to trigger anything. I thought we were definitely far enough away there. I really thought we were definitely far enough away. This is a problem for us. We're in some trouble now. At least we are triggering a lot of stuff. By which I mean, that's good because it's stopping them keeping smashing up the civilians. Oh dear. Oh, you're gonna blow that one up over there, are you? Not a lot of great shots here, really. 51% on the guy up top might be the best we've got. You can basically, you might not be able to kill him. You can do some nasty things to him, though. What's annoying here is we haven't got eyes on the gatekeeper. We really need to be able to see this gatekeeper. I'll tell you what. Why don't we chuck that out? And the reason I wanted to do that was because I'm hoping, if we're lucky, that Phil Danger might be able to get a stasis. He can't. It's not in range. Well, that's a problem. That's the big problem. That gatekeeper's going to do something horrible. So it's mimic beacon time. Yeah, take that 100%. You might crit it or something. Oh, you legend. Oh, that was well worth it.
Feind terminiert. Wurde gesehen.
Oh, wow. Four. So hang on, that's 9, 10, 11. It's 11. I think there's only two more bits of contact around. Are you getting another go, mate? What's happening? Oh, you got a free move now, haven't you? That's actually pretty handy. Because you can get to some proper cover somehow. That could be a bit dodgy if one of those is a faceless. Where are you going to go, Hans? There's no doors around there. That's going to trigger some faceless probably. You could go and hide behind here. Alright, that's probably a good shout. 51%. Well, we'll try it. We might get lucky. Or do we want to reload? Or, in fact, do we want to use impact fields or hunker? I'm going to use impact fields. Someone's going to get it. Oh, dear. I'm glad I moved hands. Oh, this has just got pretty bad. Yes. Oh, that's good. That's great, at least. I'm glad it was the gatekeeper that shot at the mimic beacon. Now, we've got a heavy rocketeer to deal with, so this might not be pretty. Oh, don't shoot the sieves. No. Okay, you missed. Nice. In your face, buddy. Elite shield bearer. Uh-oh. Crap. Oh, you bastard. Oh, Anna, sorry. We're trying. Uh-oh. Look out, Mora. This is gonna hurt. Ha-ha!
That all you got?
Yeah, exactly. That was nice. Is that them all? Ah, splendid. Who's that? Is that the Rocketeer? Alright, we've got to take out the shield bearer. And then we've got... Look at that annoying thing. It's like just out of reach the whole time. Where is Matt? He's all the way back here.
Say so.
Still can't see it, huh? Oh. Well, you're no Hans. Let's actually get Hans. What can Hans do for us? Where is he? The original nutter. What we want you to do. Sector Commander might not be a bad shout, actually, but that would be really helpful, Hans, if you could do that. Here he goes. He's on a crazy world. Hopefully don't trigger the last pod of two, wherever that is. Don't fall through the ceiling.
Oh,
total genius. Implacable. However, you can't actually... Oh, that's so good. You can get to cover again. We need you to get eyes on this beast for us, please, buddy. I mean, that's going to give us eyes. It might be too close for comfort, though. What about around there?
Wechsle position.
That'd be rubbish if we can't actually see... You can see it, brilliant. Perfect, now then, can we stasis it? No, we cannot. Okay, well then. Right. Movendo 79. It's going to do 12 to 21 damage. Why don't you just hold fire for a second. How much punch damage do you do, mate? 11 exactly. That thing's on 12. 100%. We really need you to be doing some shred for us, Mr. Sparky. You're not going to be able to get into view of that gatekeeper, are you? Oh, this is really tough. We're just all spread out all over the shop. Oh. Who's that? That's the faceless. Okay, you could really do with reloading, Aiden. Yeah, maybe that's the one for you for this turn. I'm actually really worried we don't have an answer to the gatekeeper this turn.
Hostile terminated.
I'm worried about that. Notice that I'm just kind of ignoring that faceless. Yeah, I don't really know what else to be doing at this stage. Acid bomb, can you get it? No, you can't. Oh. Can you get the sectoid out of cover at least? You can get his cover, but not him. Well, that's something. No, I want you to fan fire on that thing. Guarda bene. Okay. Alright.
Getting it done.
Mr. Mangler Matt is gonna go on a bit of a mad one. Matt the Mad One Mangler. Here we go. So let's use. Oh no, we need to give him another action first. So we're gonna use Inspire on him.
I give you strength!
Yep, that's nice. Oh, this is a terrible situation. Someone's going to get really hurt by that gatekeeper. Well, at least Aiden's got a protective field on at the moment. And Hans has got all sorts of additional armor on and stuff. So they're both not bad people to get shot. But I'm now doing something a bit crazy with Mangler as well. So we need you to get to cover. Ah, oh, it's not gonna work. We can't leave him flanked. That's just not okay. Ah, you can see that thing though. I reckon activating your shield battery is a good idea, nevertheless, regardless of what we do here. Take a shot at 63, might as well start putting some beats down on it. Oh, mate.
Adjusting sights. Could use some ammo over here.
Well, you should probably just shoot the faceless then. Wow, you can actually hit that thing? Go for it. And it's not going to be out of mind control of the Sparky unit either. In your face, mister. 14 damage. That's a lot. I thought it was 12. Perfect. Alright, that's good news. Okay, well, I think it's time for kill zone. Can we get... I mean, it's impossible to see if we're going to be able to get both the faceless and that thing. Let's hope we can. Okay. Yeah, whatever, mate. You big dribbly lard bucket. Here comes his mate. It's so just ridiculous and gross, these things. They're just like melty flesh. Let's go, man. Oh dear. Look out, hands. Is that within four squares? What's it gonna do to him? Is it shooting at Aiden? No. Oh dear, something bad is happening.
His body is disposable.
Wow. Oh, well, so that's a relatively powerful thing it just did there.
Target neutralized.
It just summoned like five zombies. That's super amazing. Yes, come on, Daniel. That's the spirit, buddy. Good night, Mr. Faceless. I just reanimated like a whole team of zombies. That was so good. What's this one doing? How did he get word that... Oh, Daniel, you're the man. Oh, so good. Oh, you're such a great team. You're like the best team ever. Yeah, sorry, loot. You were not for us. Oh, really, Dan? I guess the reload's fair enough, isn't it? Why don't you move up here?
On your order.
Take a reload. I know somebody else who needs a reload as well. Loads of zombies everywhere. Three zombies, look at that. No, yeah, three. Where's Aiden? He's like surrounded by zombies. Oh, he's actually inside a zombie. That's where Aiden is. There he is, look, he's inside a zombie. Mate, I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that. It's a bit weird. You really need to reload, unfortunately. Now, with your run and gun, where can you get to? Can you get a... There's no way you're going to be able to get a shot on that thing, is there? You're going to have to be our zombie murderer. Our zombie murdering team force. Mate. Dude. 8 health, 8 health. I thought one of them had more health than that. Well, you might as well shoot the one that's trying to impregnate you. Oh, no. Missed it. Also, that might be a good job for Mr. Pistola. Do you know, I'm tempted to shoot that in the off chance it might hurt some of those zombies. Let's try it. Yeah. Wow, that blew up everything. That's hilarious. Look at the amount of absolute carnage that bomb let off. That was so good. Of course, good old Aiden has got hang on here, sorry. Trying to think and talk. Why don't you shoot that one? Aiden's got huge reduction, 90% reduction to explosive damage, so that was pretty safe.
Nemico neutralizzato.
Now then, Phil, is there any way you can get closer? That's the problem. This thing is being really sly, like with where it is and everything. Okay. That is going to give you a shot, mate. So why don't you grapple over there?
Grapple out.
That looks great. This suit is so amazing. Okay, good. You can see it 100% from down here somehow. That was amazing. We'll take the shot then. 100%. We will definitely take that. The old through the ceiling shenanigans. It's now going to have all its defenses up again, isn't it? So we need to re-shred. Oh, free reload, yeah. Can Mora do anything? Where are you, Mora? So it's just the gatekeeper. I wonder. I don't think she's going to have range, unfortunately. So maybe she can just stop blowing up some zombies for us.
Heading out.
Alright, in which case I do. Hands are. Oh, this thing's still got so much. So much armor.
Trusting you here.
Everything within, so that would hurt us. Oh, it looks like it's not hurting us, actually. Look. Well, you might as well do that because it's going to put down a lot of damage on a lot of creatures there. It will take out two zombies. It doesn't look like it was going to hurt Aiden, but we will find out. Hopefully it won't. No, it didn't. Oh, it did hurt Aiden. Oh, sorry, Aiden. I hope you haven't gone wonky. You've, like, mind-controlled our own man. Panicked him. Oh, that's a lot of damage to have done to Aiden. Sorry.
Check it before you get too close.
Okay. Oh, one more. You're just gonna have to move up a bit more, I reckon.
On the move.
So maybe rupture, 76%. Or maybe we should take the guaranteed shot. The guaranteed shot's gonna give us a lot of shred and 8-10 damage, so let's do that. Guaranteed hit. That's nice. That's nice, mate. Okay, it's on 12 health now. It's going to be Sparky for the win. Or possibly Hans. 68%. He's standing right next to it almost. Have you got, what sort of bonus have you got from defense? I'm actually going to get closer. How far are we? We're pretty close. Come on, Hans.
So we're here.
72%. All right. Oh, Hans! No, you need to hit that, buddy. Oh no, it's not good. This isn't good. Sparky, come on, mate. You're not gonna be able to kill this thing. Nevertheless, you can hopefully do it some damage. Oh dear, this is awful. What's it gonna do? Can't believe we've actually let this thing have two turns. It's like flanking Hans. This is just a bad day for everyone. What's it gonna do now? Oh, that was so funny. All right, Daniel. Lovely. Oops.
Target neutralized.
Getting weaker by the moment. Sorry, buddy. I just like blew through the floor. Oh, that was scrappy. But we did it. We rescued. Oh, yes. That's what I was hoping for. Come on, Daniel. It's got his promotion. Oh, amazing. Well, we've got a couple of people wounded, but we've rescued 9 out of 13 civilians, so not bad at all. Welcome back, gang. Look at this, the one we've been waiting for. Daniel, congratulations, my friend. Very good. We're going to go for double tap. I've done a lot of thinking about this. I was originally going to go for serial. And that is great and everything, but double tap's going to be really useful all the time. Just going to be amazing. And that's the other reason why I put that superior scope on, because double tap, you get a slight penalty on the second shot. That has just made Daniel very powerful. Excellent. Oh, dude. Oh. 52 days. There's not going to be a 52 days, I don't think. You did a good job there, mate. You sucked up some of the paint. Oh, Aiden's out for 12 days. That does suck. That was a bit messy, that level, but we got through it.
Hello, Commander.
All right, very nice. Got 4 people wounded now, but Dave's going to be back in action very soon. Rascal, 13 days. All right, we're going to have to tighten up a little bit. We're starting to get a few people wounded. Didn't get to use the flamey thing. Some more intel, which we don't need right now. We were making contact. Here we go.
Course for Brazil.
Although if we finish this, I might go and start trying to make contact, because start trying to get the intel, because these missions sometimes lead to more scanning posts, sometimes lead to more things to scan for. Hello, Brazil. What's going on? New Brazil. What should we go for? Chile. There is a... We've already got access to 2 facilities if we need them, so... Why don't we go and get some supplies?
Avenger plotting new course.
Here we go. This is what we've been waiting for.
Hate to do this, but you're the only one who can pull this off. You know, I'd go myself if I could.
The gateway is primed. Is the subject prepared?
Ready. I hardwired what was left of the Codex brain into Rover. It should be emitting the same signal the Codex used to pass through the gateway.
Excellent. Let us begin.
A little head strapped to it.
We've already seen the Codex opening a similar rift in the field. I am sure your device will be fine.
There. We're set to record across all spectrums.
Remember, go in, take some quick readings, then come right back through, okay? Whoa, are you seeing this?
It appears our signal has been received. Increasing power.
Doesn't look like any place we've been before. Or any place on Earth, for that matter.
Perhaps this is the source. The aliens' seat of power, if you will. Secured beyond any physical limitations.
Only one way to find out.
Go on. We're counting on you.
Process did work. There was an instant where the device was in between locations. However, once that occurred, the gateway called for a second signature, an organic signature. When we could not provide one, it generated a sort of feedback pulse.
Obviously.
If the Codex creates the door, this organic signature must surely be the key.
Well, we better make sure we have the right key before we try
again. Aww.
I would hate for this to occur to something organic.
Agreed. I'll report our findings to the commander immediately.
Whoa, so good. Super cool.
We're now prepared to autopsy the body of the powerful being we recovered.
Nice.
I feel that we may be on the cusp of attaining a complete understanding of this avatar we have long sought.
Wow, good work. Very good work. We've got some top brains.
Our research is progressing as expected, Commander.
Potentially not mine, but we have got some excellent team here. Ah, well done, everyone. Hang on.
Despite the unexpected outcome of our tests on the alien psionic gate, I firmly believe the experiment itself was absolutely critical to our
avatar autopsy.
We now understand exactly how the gateway functions and what will be required should we attempt to pass through.
Still, tell you what, let's...
I must admit, I do feel some regret over the damage done to Shen's gremlin.
Yeah. Oh.
Even if it is only a machine. Our work is proceeding as expected, Commander. I can see why you would consider redirecting our efforts, Commander. We'll get to work on the new project right away. The outcome of this research can only further our advances, Commander.
The thing is, the pistol guy, I'm just not sure. He's going to be a bit underpowered, really, at this point in the game. So I suspect that medium arm is just going to be more useful, because we can fit that on anyone. Let's grab it. Duchess. There's a limited amount of names, it looks like. Increases battle scanner capacity by 2. Increases defense by 5% against enemies within 8 tiles. Increases defense by 5% by visible enemy up to 20%. So it gives him attack sense. And then an additional type attack sense. And double battle scanners. That's really sweet. I like that a lot. I know who we can give that to.
I await your orders, Commander.
What else have we got here? We might as well finish this off.
This fearsome creature, long referred to as a berserker, is clearly a genetic relation to the other mutant species we have encountered in the field. For reasons yet unknown, this particular variant is unique in that it is altogether consumed by what can only be described as blind rage, a thirst for combat, unlike any other creature we've encountered.
Prehench.
The typical mutant wasn't aggressive enough. This hulking beast seems dangerous even in death. I will be more than happy to dispose of it once I file my report.
I've never tried that out, actually. Well, there we go. We're at the end of the tech tree, pretty much. Let's finish off. Ah, we might as well do that, and then finish the avatar autopsy.
This creature represents a near-perfect fusion of human and elder DNA. Though remarkable, it appears as if the creature were unfinished. Perhaps why we were able to ultimately defeat it. Still, this can lead me to only one logical conclusion.
We had such hope for you.
I believe we have found our avatar.
Wow. 9 days. Let's get stuck in. Wow, it's all heating up. We found a way to a gate to the other world, wherever that is, whatever that is. We just need to buy them some more time. All right, Gorilla Ops. Hidden event. Yeah, let's go and see what the hidden event is. Okay. Well, the retaliation strike is 8 weeks out, so we don't have to worry about that too much. At this stage, I don't think any of these are particularly a big problem for us. So let's look at the rewards. 271 supplies. An engineer. And a scientist. Well, we might as well counter the Avatar project, I think. Even though, in a way, we definitely don't need the engineer, but the Avatar project's probably the only thing out of the three dark events that could cause us any real trouble. Sectoid Prime Mindbender, I'm quite keen to see what that is as well, so let's get over there and do that one.
Australia.
Awesome. No, Sparky, you cannot come on this mission. No. Go home. Go and get some more rest. All right, folks, gonna leave it there as always. I will see you very soon for the next part. Take care. Bye.